So, after posting that announcement video, I got about 13 people asking some burning questions for me to answer. Note, I will be reading these questions verbatim, so any grammatical errors or so will be preserved in the final video for authenticity. And like I said in the announcement video, I will unfortunately skip over a few questions that I don't really have an answer to. With all that said, here's the 1K Q&A. Also, a minor disclaimer, I've been recording this with a slight cold. I hope the audio doesn't get too messy. Bluey Productions starts off with, happy 1K subs. Huh, thanks. His first question is, inspirations for video making? Usually it's just getting a good idea for something that I can talk about, whether it be based on something that I experienced recently and just want to talk about in a video topic, or something I saw someone else do where I feel like I can put my own spin on it. His second question is, any advice to up-and-coming content makers? I've gotten a few questions involving video creating advice, so I'll be coming at this from a few angles, but one bit of advice that I can give off the top of my head is to focus on making timeless content that will be relevant long after the upload date of the video. There's a good chance that your videos aren't going to be super popular and shared by the algorithm, so views gained over time will be far more valuable. The next batch of questions comes from Juan Fernandez Pindez Mendoza. Sorry if I mispronounced that. One of his questions is, what is your favorite copy ability? It's still the mirror ability. My opinion hasn't changed much from the copy abilities list, and it's still one of my favorite abilities, bar none. What is Venezuela? It's a country located in South America. I don't know what you wanted me to answer with that. That's just what it is. And the last question is, you can make a video showing your copy ability ideas. If this is about what abilities I would like to see in the series, I doubt I'd really have any ideas for a video, to be honest. HAL Laboratories went through pretty much a good chunk of the commonly used elemental abilities, going by the most recent games like Water and Poison, so I don't really think there's any ideas that I can think of off the top of my head, outside of just weird bizarre ones like, I don't know, paper or something. Xavier Revolution starts by saying, congrats on a well-deserved 1K, my dude! You've earned it and then some. Ugh, dang it, Xavier, you're just being here being all cool and stuff. Anyhow, his questions are, 1, who are my favorite content creators currently? And I've got quite a few. Off the top of my head, I got Super Bunny Hop, Racevic, Shammy, Culture Crash, Adam Millard, the Architect of Games, GC Positive, ContraPoints, Mars Reviews, Matthew Matotis, and Soul Porpoise. All of these YouTubers definitely get my A+ seal of approval. And his second question is, what is your biggest dream/goal in life? Well, that's interesting that you ask, Zafer. My biggest dream is to survive to see 2021. I'm joking, obviously. At the rate things are going, the world is gonna end before that ever happens. Anyhow, my goal in life would be to get a dedicated following and to be able to make my current video making hobby and occasional streaming financially sustainable as opposed to the hobby that it currently is right now. Saint Stan asks, any up-and-coming games that you're looking forward to this year, or in general? Going by recent releases, Ghost of Tsushima and Solar Ash definitely have me excited. And his second question is, have you ever considered about branching out and talking about other stuff, i.e. movies, TV shows, music, etc.? Honestly, I'm considering that, but I'm gonna be approaching that cautiously due to copyright being such a minefield on YouTube. I might make a second channel, though I'm gonna have to think on that one. ShuriBazKhan55 asks, favorite horror anime? And I consume anime rather infrequently, so horror anime is a bit niche even for me. So that said, of the anime that fell into the category of horror, the only one that comes to mind is Devilman Crybaby. And hell yeah, that was a great show. Definitely worth the watch. Also, on a completely unrelated side note, JoJo Part 1 is considered a horror anime, and I mean, I guess that applies if we ignore that scene where a frog ends up getting overdramatically punched that one time. Alternative Owen asks, what is your favorite TV show? I honestly don't have a definitive favorite show, but off the top of my head, a few of my favorites are Gravity Falls, BoJack Horseman, Daredevil, iZombie, and Avatar The Last Airbender. Just going by the handful that I can remember off the top of my head. His second question is, what is your favorite spirit animal/favorite animal? Rabbits are pretty cool. Also doggos. Doggos are the best. The Reaper 520 asks, what is your favorite overlooked game / franchise? A few that come to mind are the mainline Shin Megami Tensei games, the Infamous games, if you compare how well-known they are when compared to, say, anything from Naughty Dog and Insomniac, Prey, the 2017 reboot. That game was hella great, but you'd be surprised that it went severely under the radar. Pathologic 2 is extremely good, but you'd be surprised that this game is severely under the radar. Like, almost nobody talked about that game when it came out, aside from a handful of reviewers. And then there's the Metro games, which have been getting a lot more steam after Metro Last Light came out, or the controversy with it being an Epic Store exclusive for a while, but at least Metros 1 and 2 are in the relatively niche category when you compare it to like how other FPSs are viewed nowadays in this corner of the web. And his second question is, if you could have any fictional character as a roommate, who would you pick and why? And probably Psyche K. I've been told by a friend that I'm actually the IRL version of this character, so I think we'll definitely get along, especially since I think it would be really cool to have a psychic as a roommate. And in the show, he admires people that radiate normalcy, so we'll definitely get along. Meta527II asks, best Lorule dungeon in Link Between Worlds? I haven't played a Link Between Worlds. I really think you should have asked a more open-ended question. The second question is, what is your favorite song in Xenoblade Chronicles X? I haven't had much chance to play much of the game, so I don't really have a big opinion on the soundtrack, but the main theme of Xenoblade X is fantastic. Also, one of the major composers for this game was a guy who worked on Gundam Unicorn, which is pretty dank, not gonna lie. Gator Violet asks, have you ever seen any Rian Johnson movies, aside from The Last Jedi? And going through the small list of films that he's actually worked on, the only one that I've actually watched is Knives Out. And that film was awesome. It is definitely one of those movies that I could see myself rewatching for fun. And her second question is, what is your favorite GameCube game? I've never actually owned the console, so the only ones that I played were games that were ported elsewhere, so going from the very few that I've actually played, I'd go with Metroid Prime. Jack the Lightning Ripper asks, who were your biggest inspirations for video making? Most of my inspirations were mostly older YouTubers like the Artark and Media Master. Bonus points if you remember who either of these YouTubers are. As well as current content creators that I watch, such as Super Bunny Hop, Mandalore Gaming, Racevic, and Yahtzee from Zero Punctuation. His second question is, out of all the videos you've made, which one are you the most proud of? Probably top 15 indie games. Since it took so long, and I got to gush about a few of my personal favorite games like Hyper Light Drifter. And his final question is, out of everything you participated in on YouTube, which one do you look back on the least fondly? And I'm gonna cheat here by including a few videos, but I'm gonna go with all the commentary videos since they're the only videos that I find to be kind of dull when rewatching them today. And a lot of people keep affiliating me with that era of my YouTube channel as opposed to the newer stuff that I make, and that's kind of annoying. Raven the Commentator 2001 asks, what are some of your advice for future content creators on YouTube, like new folks in the commentary community, for example? Speak of the devil. I'd mostly say focus on making content that you'd find to be fun, or find topics that are interesting. And don't be scared to branch out every once in a while to avoid burnout. Also, don't lose all hope if a video misses the mark when it comes to positive reception or views. No one got better by succeeding all the time. I think that's an important lesson everyone needs to remember now and again. And her second question is, what are your plans for the channel in the future? I'm mostly to stick to gaming content for a while since my biggest issue is the sparse uploads on this channel. Though aside from the countdowns, I'll eventually move on to make some reviews for this channel as well. Mavstation starts with, okay, so I have a few questions. His first question is, any advice for making a countdown? And I would go with focusing on finding a topic that's fun to talk about as well as something that you know others might be interested in watching. Getting that middle ground between those two is a good way to get your video to be noticed and just obviously making the video as well, since your enthusiasm will show when you're making the video. His second question is, thoughts on Ben 10? I like the classic series. Alien Force and Ultimate Alien were pretty good, and I like the handful of episodes of Omniverse that I've seen. I haven't watched the reboot, though, and honestly, I don't have any plans on seeing it, to be honest. And his third question is, what's your favorite Star Wars movie? Bit of a sad thing to admit, but I haven't actually watched any of the Star Wars films from beginning to end. But I guess an unexpected positive is that I barely got involved in the Last Jedi controversy, so there's that. I keep seeing box sets of the entire saga whenever I visit Best Buy, so I might pick it up one day and just watch all the movies just to see what I'm missing. IKG Productions asked, what inspired you to create countdowns? To be honest, boredom. I was messing around with Windows Movie Maker one day and I thought of uploading a random video to the internet and then making a countdown for fun because I liked watching top 10 lists from other people. The rest is history, I guess. His second question is, Paper Mario or Mario and Luigi? I've only played one game in each of these spin-offs, but going by the reception of the series as a whole, I'm pretty sure I'll get more enjoyment out of Mario & Luigi over Paper Mario, though I am interested in emulating the Thousand Year Door one day just to see what all the hubbub is about. Finish Duck asks, what game franchises that you've had little to no experience with would you like to get more into? Going by just the game series that I've gotten into in the last few years, it would be Yakuza, Shin Megami Tensei, the Mario RPG spin-offs, Resident Evil, Fallout, and the Dragon Quest games. His second question is, favorite boss/bosses from the Sly Cooper series? Just going off my memory, since it's been a while since I played each game, Mugshot was a great puzzle boss, Clockwork was definitely fun, Rajan was a standout as a fight with Murray, Gene Bison was a nice change of pace since you weren't fighting him directly, General Tsao was a blast and a half, and the dragon that you fight in the same chapter was really memorable. And the final battle with Dr. M was a great send-off to the series, before Thieves in Time was a thing. And his third question is, favorite meme? Well, as of recording, the cake meme has taken over my life, so I'll go with that. Also, the Knuckles approving a meme, that one was also pretty good. Tanuki Player starts off with congratulations on getting 1k. You deserve it, and I hope you keep growing. Thanks, Tanuki. I appreciate it. Anyhow, her questions are, 1. What are some of your favorite films? I don't have a super duper definitive list, but just going off the top of my head, I'd have to go with Into the Spider-Verse, Knives Out, Infinity War, The Matrix films, and Pacific Rim. Yeah, I need to watch more movies. I'll try to fix that in the future. And her second question is, what are some of your favorite characters in any piece of fiction? That's a pretty broad question, so I'll just narrow it down to video games for now. And going by that, I'd go with Zeke from Infamous 2. He's just a fun guy with a great character arc. Mei from Night in the Woods, due to how hard I personally relate to her. Jack Frost from the Shin Megami Tensei series for how funny he is in every game. Ricky from Xenoblade Chronicles for being a better character than you'd initially think. And Dark Pit from Kid Icarus Uprising for being a fun antagonist to deal with. And the final question comes from Acroloth2160, whose first question is, most unorthodox food combination that you enjoy regardless? A little while ago, I took a bit of baked ziti, and then I dipped it into a little bit of Frank's Red Hots, and it tastes pretty good. His second question is, how do you keep yourself entertained during the quarantine? And for me, it was playing open world games, and specifically the ones where you interact with NPCs, which was the best method of keeping sane during that time period. Most people would go with Animal Crossing, but for me, Yakuza 0 was the best, since it covered that as well as just being a fun game overall. And his third question is, favorite band/musicians? Well, anything from the Toxic Avenger is automatically a win. And that's all the answers that I have. Thanks for all the questions, guys, it was fun writing this video and such. Looking forward to the next milestone, which will either be 2,000 subs or 2,500 subs, depending on how long it takes to reach around those milestones. Anyhow, this has been the Renegade Master, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. I'm signing out.